So when you look, it's important. Instead, he invited him to reflect upon the deity of Christ. It is as if Jesus said, do you really know what you're saying? Now, I've had my grandpa say that before.
Come on.
You know. And look, in the times that he said that to me, it wasn't times when I was being good either.
Amen. Come on.
It was times when I'm being bad, right? You know, I remember when I talked back to my grandma, you know. When I was little, now all of you know how that is. You know, there's times that you've not honored your father and your mother, and you talked back to them, and you put your mouth on them. Hey, and a lot of times, you know, it's when I said that, my grandpa said, boy, what did you just say?
Right.
And I'd be like, Because if I knew I went much further than that, you know, he said, you go over there and tell her that you're sorry. That's the woman that gave birth to you. That's the woman. Now, Tracy, you know where I got it. Amen. That's when I did that to Jonathan, I was just going along the line in what I've been taught. So when you look at it, as if Jesus said, do you really know what you're saying? He said, what? He said, shall I do that I may inherit eternal life? Think about what he's saying, the rich young ruler. The focus of the man's question is, what shall I do? That's the problem. He can't do nothing.
That's right. Come on. That's right.
See, at the very beginning of this, you know, what you got to realize is when he comes and he says, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Jesus saw the problem right away.
Right.
He said, it's not what you should do, it's what God should do. Amen? Hey, it's not that we love God, it's that God loved us. Johnny said it this morning. He read the scripture. You know, when you look at it, hey, it's not about what we can do to obtain these things. It's no good that we've done. It's not that God looked down through time and he saw that Scott was going to be a good person. He saw I was going to be lost, Vicky. He saw I was going to be on my way to the devil's hell. And you know what he still did? He reached out in love and mercy and grace. And hey, what did he do? He swept me unto himself. He took me out of the deep miry clay and he placed my feet upon the rock. It wasn't anything that I had done.
Amen.
That's the beauty of the whole situation. You know, you think about it, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? He thought that eternal life was a matter of earning or deserving, not relationship. You know, Charles Stanley got me this morning. He's good. You know, and I think about the first question he asked. Now, he preached out of Galatians 5, wasn't it? I think it was. Now, I preached it out of Ephesians. It's a message that was very similar to what he said. And he asked the question that I'd asked. He said, you know, because he was actually coming from the reference that I've been saved, now what? What do I do?
Amen.
In other words, how shall I live? He said, would it surprise you? I remember the question he asked. If I told you this morning that, you know, if I told you that I couldn't be saved in myself. You know, when you look at it, that's true. And it's important that we observe. When you look at it, he said, one of the things that sticks out to me in this encounter is how close this man was to salvation. He bowed down on his knees to Jesus here. You see that by mere closeness of relationship made him closer to salvation than anything that he could do. But the key is that he didn't want Jesus to be his Savior. He wanted Jesus to show him the way that he could be his own Savior. That's the problem. And I can tell you this morning that we cannot save ourselves. And I'm going to tell you, just like them pieces, now I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go back, just like them pieces that was laying out on the rag, when I pulled them up, Mike, I made a mess of the whole situation. And I'm going to tell you, my life was the same way. Hey, when I pulled up the rag, I made a mess of the whole situation. Not in the sense it wasn't a rag and it wasn't a bunch of bearings and thrush washers and collar pins and all that stuff. But hey, when I pulled it up, Donald, hey, I screwed it up. Let me just put it very plainly this morning. Boy, my life was a mess. And then I made foolish statements, even in that life. I said, well, if you want to go to church, I told Tracy, you go ahead. I don't think I need that God thing, but that was the furthest thing from the truth. And the minute those words uttered from my mouth, I knew what I just said was a lie. Amen.
Amen.
And I was convicted. And then she said, well, you know, the preacher's come by, and he's come by to see us, and he wants to talk to you. And I said, well, send him on by. Because, you know, I thought I was smart. Thought I had to answer for everything, you know.
That's right.
Johnny, just ask me, what do you need to know? You know, that's how I felt. And I was foolish to think that way, you know. And I think it's funny that he says, and he makes reference even to what Johnny was saying this morning, that he uses the foolishness of preaching to confound the wise. Isn't that odd? When you look at it here, the key is that he didn't want Jesus to be his Savior. He wanted Jesus to show him the way that he could be his own Savior. How do I know that? Because of what he said. He said, what shall I do?
Come on.
It's not what you can do. But it's all about what Jesus can do. Do you want Jesus to save me this morning, or are you trying to save yourself? The man, you know, you think about it, even in the lives, we know that this is making reference to someone who is lost. But let me ask you this morning, if you've been saved and you know Jesus as your personal Savior this morning, it goes further than just being saved. Do you want Jesus to be the Lord of your life?
Come on, that's right.
Do you want Him to be the Master? Do you want to be Him, the one that He's in control, the one that is set in order? It says the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. Do you want Him to be the one that's leading you, or do you want to lead yourself? Knowing Jesus comes first is one of the most important things in your life that you'll ever learn. Now, that sounds simple, but I'm going to tell you, it's harder to live than it is just to say. You say that Jesus is first, yet in our lives many times He's way down there somewhere on the list. Now, we need to examine ourselves this morning and really look, because if you say, well, even here, you know, this man right here thought he was righteous, right? What did he say? And I noticed this. Ain't it funny that Jesus didn't even argue with him over his righteousness?